In the first video of this CDR series, we defined an HIV cluster as a network of people experiencing rapid HIV transmission. We noted that health departments need to know about these clusters so they can work to stop this rapid HIV transmission in communities as quickly as possible. But how do health departments find out about HIV clusters? Well, there are several methods that they can use to detect them. To have as complete a picture of the cluster as possible, health departments sometimes use multiple cluster detection methods at the same time. One common way a health department may be alerted about a potential HIV cluster is by hearing from community-based organization staff members who offer HIV care and prevention services or doctors who provide HIV care. These providers or staff may notice an unusual increase in people coming in for HIV-related care, testing, or prevention services and inform the health department about this. Another way that health departments find out about HIV clusters is from their employees who provide direct services to people with HIV. These staff are called Disease Intervention Specialists, DIS, or field staff. They may notice a larger than usual number of people who share a behavior that allows HIV to spread, such as sharing unclean needles or syringes. A third way that HIV clusters are detected is by health department staff who collect and analyze HIV case report data. These staff look at changes over time and may notice increases they would not normally expect. HIV changes over time, and it evolves differently in each person. Because of that, a fourth way that health departments detect HIV clusters is by analyzing the HIV strains present in the community and seeing if they are related. This process looks at the viral mutations and the virus's genetic characteristics to determine how closely the strains are related. It does not show who shared HIV with whom. Laboratory tests only show that HIV strains are related. This last detection method can help determine whether groups of people who seem like they have related HIV strains based on field interviews, for example, are in fact part of the same cluster. All four of these methods are beneficial because they help demonstrate both an increase in cases and the potential that these cases may be related, which are signs of rapid HIV transmission. The next video in this series will discuss how Southern health departments, healthcare providers, and community-based organizations respond to clusters.